Hello and welcome. I'm James Murphy. Did you know that not all exceptions in Python derive from the built-in exception class? That's right, not all exceptions are capital exceptions. This is almost correct though. Let's see what happens if we try to raise something that's not an exception. Here I try raising a string and I get an error message that says all exceptions must derive from base exception, not exception. Okay, so all exceptions have to be base exceptions, but what's the difference between a base exception and an exception? Well, here's the official documentation. A base exception is just the base class for all built-in exceptions. On the other hand, a plain old exception is for all built-in non-system exiting exceptions and all user-defined exceptions. Clearly, the Python documentation is telling me that for my own exceptions, I should be inheriting from exception, not base exception. So what are the built-in system exiting exceptions that it's talking about here? We can find out a little bit lower in the documentation by looking at the exception class hierarchy. From this list, we can see that Python has only three built-in exceptions that are base exceptions, but not exceptions. Looking at the first two, now we know what the authors of the documentation meant when they said non-system exiting exceptions. System exit and keyboard interrupt generally cause your Python program to stop. Generator exit, on the other hand, doesn't cause your program to stop, and I'm not quite sure why it's a base exception and not just an exception. My intuition tells me that it should go wherever stop iteration goes, but I'm sure there were good reasons for doing this. But let's move on and stick with the main intent of separating base exception from exception. Let's investigate why it's useful to separate exiting exceptions from non-exiting ones. Consider the following example. Suppose somewhere deep down in our code, something fails and we want to exit the program, so we call sys.exit. Here, we've wrapped the whole thing in a try-except, where we're catching all capital exceptions. As you can see, none of the print statements execute. That's because sys.exit raised a system exit exception, which is a base exception, not a capital exception. What we're assuming here, and what is normally the case when you're programming, is that for exceptions, you want to catch logical errors, or failures of functions to succeed. Handling these kind of business logic exceptions is generally what you mean to do when you use a try-except. This is a very different type of situation than what's going on if somewhere in the code someone tries to exit the program. Generally speaking, if someone's trying to exit the program, you really shouldn't be stopping them. Now, of course, you can catch a system exit if you want to do something specific in that situation, but normally when you say catch all the exceptions, this is not what you have in mind. If you want to catch all the exceptions, then you just use a bare except or an except base exception. Keep in mind though that in my opinion, catching all exceptions is almost always a bad idea. In my opinion, you should always prefer to use the most specific kind of exception that you can think of. If you expect a type error or a value error, then use them. Don't depend on except base exception or except exception to just catch everything. I know it's really tempting to just use a bare except because it's less to type. Using a bare except or an except exception is way too broad, and it will often lead to catching and possibly silently handling errors that you weren't expecting, like here I passed the wrong kind of argument to system.exit. But during the execution of the program, I have no way of knowing that. Moving on, let's see what can go wrong if you do try to catch all exceptions instead of just non-system exiting ones. So I'm going ahead and running this program. It's doing work, it's doing work, it's doing work. And I decide that it's taking too long, I want to kill this program. So I go ahead and hit Control-C and try to kill it. No matter how many times I hit Control-C, the exception handler is not allowing me to exit the program. If I want to kill the program, I have to kill the terminal itself or kill the Python process at the operating system level. However, if I just catch capital exceptions, then I can kill it with Control-C, and I get a keyboard interrupt. This is a common mistake that people make, especially when accepting user input from the terminal. As a side note, if you really just want to kill Python and not ask it to shut down nicely, you can do that using the os.exit function. You can see that when we run this code, nothing is printed out because Python is killed. It doesn't raise an exception like sys.exit does. OS exit just kills the program. most of the time you only really want to do this after you forked a new process and then want to kill it. But it's good to know just in case you have to. Finally, what's the deal with GeneratorExit? GeneratorExit is not a system exiting exception, but it is a base exception, not a capital exception. A generator exit is raised inside a generator when you call the generator's close function before the generator is finished. Here we create a generator and call its next method once. It just yielded 0 and now it's paused. While it's paused, we call its close method and we see that gen exit is printed out. We see gen exit printed because the generator exit was caught by this accept handler. Notice, however, that we re-raise the exception, but we still don't see a trace back. That's because, much like a stop iteration used in for loops, a generator exit is not really an error. A generator raising generator exit is just Python's way of telling you that the generator is done. Python silently handles a generator exit just like it silently handles a stop iteration for a for loop. Again, honestly, I'm not sure why this is a base exception and not an exception. In any case, though, that's all of the built-in base exceptions in Python that aren't themselves capital exceptions. You can technically make your own base exceptions by inheriting directly from base exception, but the documentation tells you that you shouldn't do this. Well, that's all I've got on exceptions. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned a little bit. If you liked the video, please consider subscribing. Share it with your friends, and as always, slap that like button an odd number of times. See you next time.